I'm here to share some experience that I had with the thank part of the Trinity of inspire, invite, and thank. And I'd like to share the experience of getting in touch with every identifiable giver in our congregation simply in order to say thank you and to collect their stories about why giving to our congregation is an important practice in their lives. So on an annual basis, and usually in January, we call every single family we have a little script. We often end up leaving a message on an answering machine, but actually more recently we seem to get people at home. We've called to simply say thank you for the fact that they have been a donor to the ministry of the congregation in the past 12 months. Bracket, we don't know what people, how much people have given, and perhaps even as how often they've given. We simply know that they have given. And so we are calling to say thank you. The response to that is twofold. One, they are often surprised to be thanked and then say thank you for being thanked, which is always a fun experience. And the second is that it often leads to a brief conversation about what is important about the ministry of the congregation and why they have been supported. It might have been that their children have been in the church school program that they've appreciated, or that they are aware that we have a refugee family that have been settled in the past 12 months, that sort of thing. We ask people if we can share that information with the leadership, because that's kind of encouraging and nice to share good news. And if they have any concerns, we also ask if that can be shared with the appropriate person. We have continued that in a more focused and intentional way in the COVID era. As we quickly were discovering, people were making additional gifts to the congregation because we were striving to continue our ministry, especially to feeding the underhoused and homeless folks in downtown Toronto. And so we have a practice now of every month phoning or emailing the people that have made an additional donation. And many people have responded to the various ministries that we have been sustaining over the time. Now, after 6 months, decided that we are not going to wait until January, but we are going to now be getting in touch with everyone who has been a routine donor on a monthly basis, whether that is through PAR or Canada Helps or through envelopes or checks that have come in. So saying thank you to those people who have been so important to the way in which we've been able to sustain our ministry through this challenging time. The thanking is always appreciated, and it's actually one of the most pleasurable tasks. It is an email or a phone call that will make you feel good, as well as offering a way of being, offering gratitude for people's generosity, especially at this challenging time. Thanks very much. Try it.